You've got energy, right, Alex? Yes. Perfect. Today, I'm going to cover data aggregation. Here's another one of those terms that people in the marketing world can be a bit intimidated by, because it does sound a little bit mathy. But actually, data aggregation is sort of the key for the human eye to be able to easily understand data. Raw data to the human eye looks a lot like a bunch of numbers. Take, for example, a table with your cost for every day of the year. That would be a table with 365 rows, which is some serious scrolling time. The aggregated version of this could be something like cost for every month of the year. Now you have a simple table with just 12 rows giving you a month-by-month view of your spend. That's a simple example, but the principle of data aggregation is what makes a marketing data tool like Funnel so powerful. By creating custom dimensions, you can use them to slice and dice data, which is effectively aggregating it in different ways. Let's do one more example. If you imagine trying to look at all of your native conversions from each platform by country, you need columns for each platform segmented by country, and let's say you run activity on Google, Facebook, LinkedIn, and Bing. All of a sudden you have a big ugly table, which isn't exactly easy on the eye. Instead, you can utilize data aggregation by creating a country dimension that automatically combines country data together from all of your platforms. Then you have a nice, neat table with each country, easily visualizing a summary of your native conversions across all platforms. Ultimately, data aggregation is about summarizing your data so you can visualize it in a way that tells a story quickly and efficiently. That's it for this week's Funnel Tip. If you have any questions, shoot us a message. Thank you.